Okay, I'm here again with my GPL example, which we do before. I think it's the most useful example because we spend with this example a lot of time. But here I will go to the GPL init. We talk about the clock enable because we need to enable the clock before we start work with the GPLs. Here we configure the default state of this pin, that in case that we start to initialize this pin, we force this pin to stay low. In case that our application have some proprietary settings requirements, that for example after initialization the pin must be always high, then we can change this here. But then we can found the init structure. We can see here. We define the init structure variable, the GPL underscore init struct, and we put into this struct some values, and then on the end we called the GPL init when the one parameter is the let GPL port, which is my define let, and then as the second parameter is this structure. Then into this structure we save all information about the behavior of the pin, and when we called the GPL HL GPL init, this pin will get this parameters. And the parameters inside the struct is the pin, mode, pull function, and the speed. Okay, now how to discover which structure to define. And what is the name of the structure, the type? For me, the easiest way, one way is to look into the help file. I more than less like, because we know that the initialization always starts with the init. Then we look directly into the drivers, into the GPL drivers, which are here, the .c. Usually the init function is the first. We can see, and here we know we see the parameters. First parameter is the GPLX, and here he advise us that the it must be in range from the A to I, from A to I, and second parameter must be the init struct. Then we can copy this part and define it into our initialization in case that is necessary. Okay, then we put the struct. Then how discover the parameters of the struct? You can use the dot convention. Then usually all the IDEs try to advise you. Then you click on the dot and he select show for you alternate of the possible parameters, or press control space to force this whispering. In case that you are not sure, I advise here to mark this type definition, click with the right click and use the go to definition. It's always the same in the IR, Kyle, or the Atolic. And then you can see what are the parts of this structure. And here also you can see that if you want to see what you can put inside this to refer this define. And for example, I am not sure which pin definition can be here. Then I copy this. I press Ctrl C, usually Ctrl F. Okay, and I search for it. It's usually a little bit lower only. And you see, as a pin, you can put all these parameters. Okay, then why we cannot try it on your own? I think it's very it will be very good experience. I do this in my KL. Then what to do? On our discovery kit, we have the let, but let is already defined, that I think it's no reason to do this again. But we have also button. then we can define this button. Why not? Okay, then we use this definition, and I think we can only copy this one, the init struct. I think it's not necessary. And we define this pin in our main here in the section user code begin to. I think it will be good option. But definitely we need to define our private variable, which will be called button. Why not? Okay. Then I use the button here. And I start with the initialization. But first, what I forget is check which button and where is the button. What is the button position and the type? This I have here. Okay. And the button, user blue, it's connected to pin PC13. Then we need to remember. On this button is also pull-up resistor. Then if the button is pressed, the on the microcontroller pin is 0. If it's not pressed, there is the VDD. This mean 1. Then it's pin PC13. Okay. Then remember this. Then first of all, we talk about the clocks. Then before we want to work with the periphery, we need to enable clocks. If we know here that in the GPIO init we enabled the clocks for the GPIO A, but our pin is GPIO C. We can simply copy this part, and here we only change the GPIO N to GPIO C. This enable the clock for us, for the pins PC, and we can also init this pins. Then we type button. I can use the dot. And first, I definitely select the pin, because this is the most important part. Which pin to select? I'm not sure, I must say. Then I can return into my H file. Here I search for the GPIO pins definition, and I have a lot of pins. We know our pin is 13. Then we here select the PC 13. I put it here. Everything okay. Then we again need to define all most of the parameters, because not only one. Usually undefined parameter can be very dangerous, because we are not sure what can be there stored during the initialization. We select the mode. If you remember, we have outputs, inputs, alternate function, analog function, but the button will be definitely digital input. We again look into our age. Here is the definition of our structure. We search for the mode definitions. Yes, it's here. And if you can see input, output, then for us is valid the floating input mode. Then I will use this one in my project. It will be pin PC13 and it will be configured as an input. Button. Then we select the pull-up or pull-down mode. Again, into the H file. I think the pull-up, pull-down will be here. I don't want to use the pull-up or pull-down, because on the pin is pull-up already as an external component. Then the speed. I can set it as the low, but speed is not used if we configure this pin as an input, but for sure I will let it here. And the last part is the alternate function. I think the alternate function will be defined here in the alternate function settings. Okay, it's related to the other peripherals then, because we don't have the alternate function, we can delete this part. Okay, and now we need to init this pin. It was only we fill now only the structure, but now we need to call the function for init. Then it start the HL underscore GPIO underscore and then the name init. Then the first parameter is the GPIO port. If we look here into go to definition, the GPIO port, he advised us it must be the name GPIO X. The X name will be name of the port. Then here we put the GPIO and X, it's our in our case C. And then the pointer to structure. And here we need to use the end symbol. Put the button here, and this is everything. After that, our pin will be initialized as the input. Then I think we can test this, because okay, we initialize the pin, and we can test here. We can, for example, delete the delay. It's not necessary, and definitely. We can here put the HL underscore GPIO as usually, and we can look what the available functions we have, and I think the read pin will be the correct function. We want to read the button. We put again the GPIO X. It will be the GPIO underscore GPIO C. And then the name of the pin, we can copy it from here, the GPIO underscore pin underscore 13. Okay, but what we get back? We can go to the definition of this function and you see the return parameter is the GPIO pin state. We can check what is the GPIO pin state, again with the go to definition. And you can see that the state can be set or reset. We know when the pin is pressed, then we are on the zero. Then we check when the pin is pressed. Then I put here the if. And if this pin is equal to reset, then we can do something. Then do something. I think the toggle is not so happy option. Then I think we here can find something better. HL underscore GPIO underscore. We can look. I think we can use the write pin. We can copy this part. It's the same. And the last part is again the pin state. And when the button is pressed, we set the pin as a set. Okay. And we don't need to toggle anymore. And we put also else. When the pin is not pressed, then, this one. When the pin is not pressed, we reset the pin. Then now I can compile the code. We download the code into the microcontroller. Okay, it's there. We run the code and we check the behavior. If we press the button, the LED is on. If you release the button, LED is off. Then it's working how we want it. It's perfect. And the pin was configured with our own. The one remark, maybe in the GPIO init, you are wondering why we not using here the GPIO A here and here also the GPIO pin, the correct names. which have been reused in the LAT. You see here is something LAT underscore GPO underscore port. Where is this defined? Because I used in the kubemx the label for the naming of this pin, he for me named this pins very in the fix name. If we want to know where the definition is, we can go to the definition. It's in the mxconstants.h file, and you can see the GPO port is defined as the GPO A, and the let pin is as the GPO underscore pin underscore 5. Then here I really put there the same parameters as we do here in our button. Then now you know how to configure the pins. Now you definitely can set the pins as the inputs and also as the outputs.